Joining me in the studio today is the Conservative MP for Rochester and Strood, Mark Reckless, and Labour's prospective parliamentary candidate for Hastings and Rye, Sarah Owen. Welcome to you both. First, let's talk about UKIP. You probably don't want to talk about this, Mark, do you? But the party pulled off a stunning victory in Eastleigh last week. The Lib Dems won, but only just, and both they and the Conservatives saw their share of the vote fall by 14%. UKIP's share rose by a whopping 24%. You and a lot of your colleagues must be ever so worried, Mark.
I think it's a tragedy. I mean, having encouraged the Prime Minister to cut the EU budget, to change at least our Conservative policy, we haven't got a majority in Parliament, but you know, we want an in-out referendum on the EU. Yet we see in Eastleigh, we and UKIP with a similar policies, we've got over half the vote, yet the election was won by the Euro-fanatical Liberal Democrats with less than a third of the vote. And I just... I hope that we will get with that referendum to give people a chance to vote for an independent country. It's what I've been campaigning for over 20 years.
Well, exactly, and you've been a thorn in the Prime Minister's side on this issue, but having won that from him, you then see UKIP pick up that huge swing of the vote. What else do you do?
Well, I think come the general election, people will face a choice between David Cameron as Prime Minister carrying on with the economic policies of trying to deal with the deficit, or Ed Miliband and Ed Balls, who created that mess in the first place. And people will also, I think, have a very clear choice between a Conservative government that would give an in-out referendum so people can decide once and for all on the EU, or a Labour Party which I think wants to deny people a referendum, but we're not quite sure what their policy is.
Okay, so well, we won't talk about your policy on Europe, although Mark would like us to. I mean, Labour didn't do that well, let's face it, in Eastleigh either. Fourth place, a very, very slight increase in their share of the vote. The danger for you is that UKIP becomes the party that people go to now to express their frustrations with the government, not you.
Well, I think, first of all, to say that Eastleigh is a by-election, it's a snapshot in time. And I'd say that the UKIP surge in Eastleigh says a lot more about the Conservatives' position in the South East than it does in Labour's. I mean, this was not a target seat for us, it was a target seat for the Conservatives. And I think it's an indictment on people don't know where David Cameron stands anymore. Is he left? Is he right?
And that's why you're seeing... He stands on Europe, though, which is more than they're sure about Ed Miliband.
Well, people are more clear about where Nigel Farage clearly stands and the values that they hold. And it's very difficult for people like Mark in his party. And it says that David Cameron is dealing with a crisis within his party and it's playing out in the ballot boxes.
The other danger, though, Mark, all the analysts say this, is actually, forget UKIP, the danger is Labour, and the problem you have with UKIP is they're going to split the Conservative vote and people like Sarah will win seats from you.
Well, I think we have to keep working to improve the economy, to deal with the debt that Labour left us. And I think it's only 2 months since we've been clear that actually, you know, the Conservative Party does want a referendum on Europe. We need an in-out referendum. We've got to deal with this issue once and for all. And I hope over the next 2 years that we'll get that message and be clear to people that if you want, you know, to vote for an independent Britain, then you need to vote for a Conservative government that will give you that chance.
OK, well, we'll watch with interest. We'll move on now. It's